In a world where next-gen cards have been announced, or in the case of Radeon, a month from being announced, is there a purpose to the flagship cards like the Radeon 6950 XT? Well, you know what? The answer might surprise you. Thank AMD and Newegg for sponsoring this video. Now, before I get into the does it make sense to buy a 6950 XT, I want to get into a little bit of a breakdown on the card. AMD Radeon 6950 XT on paper looks almost exactly the same as the AMD Radeon 6900. The GPU core is the Navi 21 XTX. It has 80 compute units, 60 gigabytes of GDDR6, and 128 megabits of Infinity Cache, just like the Radeon 6900 XT. Okay, Robey, but there has to be a difference, right? Well, of course there is. And that's in the core clocks, which go from 2015 megahertz to 2100 megahertz on the game side, and from 2200 megahertz to 2310 megahertz on the boost side. Plus, the memory speed is increased from 16 gigabits per second to 18 gigabytes per second. There's some other minor differences in power and also in Infinity Cache speed as well. But you're probably looking and thinking, what are we really looking at here from like a raw power perspective? And that's the interesting thing about this card. When it released, it was trading blows in some games with a much higher and much pricier 3090 Ti, which for an $1,100 card at the time was fighting an almost $2,000 card, which is quite a feat. But today things have changed, and these flagship GPUs have dropped way down in price. You can go over and pick up a flagship GPU from AMD like the RX 6950 XT for as little as $949. Is it worth it? I mean, Radeon is on the horizon with RDNA 3, and a 4000 series is just a few weeks away. Why should I get a card like an AMD Radeon 6950 XT right now? Well, to answer that question, let's just take a look at a smattering of games using the Radeon 6950 XT. No additives, just bare bones, raw power. You can see just how much oomph we've got at 1440p with the Radeon 6950 XT. Now let's start with Tiny Tina's Adventure. It's running at the highest graphical settings. We're looking at 125.05 frames per second. Assassin's Creed Valhalla, again, ultra high preset, you're seeing 117 frames per second. Far Cry 6 with ultra presets, you're looking at 144 frames per second. And finally, you've got Cyberpunk 2077 with ray tracing on ultra presets. We're seeing an average of 27.21 frames per second. Now I'm gonna hit on Cyberpunk 2077 a bit more later, but there is a reason that I've put it in here. Okay, Robey, so those are some pretty solid numbers. And you would be right, they are. For 1440p games, when most of these things you're kind of aiming for 60 frames per second as the goal, and they're single player titles, those are great numbers. But you mentioned trading blows with an RTX 3090 Ti. But what about something like similar, albeit still a little bit more expensive, the RTX 3090? Well, in all of the games I listed here, the only game that Nvidia beat the 6950 XT in was Cyberpunk 2077. Sure, it is worth mentioning that all of these games are optimized for AMD, but that doesn't mean that they are intentionally hindering the performance of an RTX 3090 either. And the inclusion of Cyberpunk 2077 as a clearly Nvidia title will kind of prove my point on this a little bit later. Now, are you ready for some magic? Because honestly, this is the best part of this whole thing. See, I told you there was no special additives or anything else that was gonna make this thing special, but we're gonna add some special sauce when it comes to AMD that's gonna make this a whole lot better. See, more specifically, we're gonna talk about what's called Smart Access Memory and Fidelity FX Super Resolution, or FSR. Smart Access Memory is a technology that gives the CPU access to more of the GPU's RAM than it previously could, meaning it could help fix slowdowns and any other issues that might occur in demanding workloads, AKA, you know, like games. So how do I turn on Smart Access Memory? Well, you need to enable what's called Resize Bar and above 4G decoding in the BIOS. The new boost to games has gotten so popular that in some of the more modern motherboard BIOSes, there's simply an option just right up there on the top that you can click and enable Resize Bar and turn everything on the BIOS very, very easily. Once you get finished setting things in the BIOS, head back to the Adrenaline software and it will show you with your 6950 that smart access memory is enabled, and you can even turn it off if you want to see what kind of boost you want to get by turning it on and off. Let's talk about another magic here, and that's called FSR. AMD's FSR, or Fidelity FX Super Resolution, is a type of rendering technique that boosts frame rate in games and allowing GPUs like the 6950 XT to punch above their weight class, even when it's a Titan already. You've heard it compared to things like DLSS, or Deep Level Super Sampling from NVIDIA, or even XeSS, which is Intel similar technologies. Now, without getting mired in the technical details, let's just take those games that we ran and apply FSR. So for Tiny Tina's Adventure, this time using FSR set to performance, we jump from 133 frames per second up to 178.98. For Assassin's Creed Valhalla, setting FSR to performant, we saw 127 frames per second jump up to 167 frames per second. For Far Cry 6, we saw 146 FPS jump up to 165 FPS. Cyberpunk 2077, remember what was only 27 frames per second? Well, now it's 95.08 frames per second. That's good and all, but you said the 3090 also got a boost, so how did it fare with FSR on? Well, in every case, you can see here that the 6950 XT actually outperformed the more expensive 3090. Oh, and even on Cyberpunk 2077, we let the 3090 cheat a bit and gave it DLSS at ultra performance, and we saw it still lose with 95 frames per second beating out 86.05. So this brings me to my first point as to why getting a 6950 XT today may still be a good choice. See, given the agnostic nature of things like FSR, meaning it works on any card, AMD is betting that because of the open source nature and the fact that game developers can give improvements to all GPUs, there will be mass adoption of the technology, which, given the number of games that continues to be added and adopt their technology, including the NVIDIA favored Cyberpunk, this seems to be showing that AMD might be right and might be onto something. And unlike DLSS 3.0 that was just announced with the 4090, this technology, as it improves, just like DLSS has, will continue to improve the performance of cards like the 6950 XT that you're getting for less than $1,000, but maybe punching way above its weight class. But guys, we're not done yet. So what about enabling smart access memory and FSR? Then what happens? Well, going through our four titles again, Tiny Tina's Adventure, we saw frames stay about the same with a slight dip, but essentially within the margin of error. For Assassin's Creed though, we saw 167 frames per second jump up to a very much higher 197 frames per second. For Far Cry 6, it was very similar to Tiny Tina's Adventure, where frame rate stayed around the same. But finally, for Cyberpunk 2077, we saw another leap of 95.08 frames per second up to 103.85 frames per second. Now, with all of the boost, you can see how much more these improvements in technology have taken the raw power of a graphics card like the 6950 XT, and in some cases, like Cyberpunk 2077, literally given it four times the amount of performance. Oh, in case you were wondering, these cards are no slouch when it comes to multiplayer either. For Apex Legends, playing like the pros, basically optimizing visual settings for the absolute fastest frames per second, you're looking at north of 281 FPS at 1440p. For Call of Duty fans, same visual settings, optimizing for frame rate, you're looking at north of 260.2 FPS at 1440p. And finally, for Fortnite fans looking to jump into the latest patch, which may have changed the number a bit, but let's just say for you 360Hz monitor users, you aren't gonna have any issues if you do low visual settings and optimize for frame rate. Which takes me to the final point of this whole thing and the most important one for this video. When you think about getting a card now, like a 6950 XT, or waiting for, you know, an up and coming card from AMD or NVIDIA, what do you actually need? Because when you look at putting this card up against games like Cyberpunk 2077 and having north of 100 frames per second on a game that only needs 60 FPS and is already pushing the limits of graphical capabilities, I mean, that game is beautiful. Well then, what does a $1,600 card, or even an $1,100 card or $1,200 card really going to get you that you aren't going to get for a sub $1,000 card? AMD is going to continue to improve the technology, and the best part about it is that unlike Team Green, you're going to be getting the benefits as well, and you aren't going to be paying the price. Oh, and these two technologies, Smart Access Memory and FSR, aren't the only bag of tricks that Team Red has up its sleeve. I mean, there's also AMD Super Resolution, which is an in-driver upscaling feature similar to FSR. You've got Radeon Boost, Radeon Anti-Lag, FreeSync, and AMD Noise Suppression, to name just a few, all powered by the ever-growing toolset that is AMD Adrenaline software. And it isn't just about unlocking your game performance, like FSR, but also your game experience with things like Anti-Lag, and stream capabilities with things like Noise Suppression. All these things come with the Radeon 6950 XT, and will continue to grow and expand for you as well as adopters of RDNA 3.0 and beyond. But it's not about what I think, it's also about what you think, because ultimately, the choice is yours. But I hope this video helps you consider your options versus with just going with the flow of so many people out there when it comes to consumerism. There is a lot of life still in these cards, and there is always new technology that's gonna be on the horizon, whether it's RDNA 3.0 or 4.0 or whatever. The most important thing to know is what you need, and if this card works for you, you know what? Maybe even save a little money in the long run. But tell me your thoughts, and maybe, you know what? You can win a little cash in the process. First and foremost, you need to leave a quality comment down below, along with liking and subscribing to the channel. And when I say quality comment, it doesn't need to be positive. It just needs to be something you liked or didn't like about the video, what surprised you, etc., about the graphics cards or the numbers we showed. Just not, I deserve to win. Can I has a free 6950 XT, which I wish you would have watched the stream, which we did this whole build with this card, because we gave away a 6650 XT and a 6750 XT. Anyway, we just can't have something else weird or lame like that. You also need to ensure we have a way to reach you via your YouTube profile, like your email. So put your email in your YouTube profile, because we're going to be giving away $25 to one lucky comment down below that is worldwide, as long as you can accept PayPal or Venmo. If you don't have an email in your YouTube profile, well then we can't tell you you've won, and therefore you just can't win. So, are you considering picking up a 6950 XT or a current generation AMD card? Were there points that I made about considering what you need that may have resonated? And were you surprised by the impact of smart access memory and FSR when it came to the 6950 XT, or were you surprised by the 6950 XT? I would love to know all that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a new video right here on Robeytech. Did you know we have a live stream channel for special builds and events? In fact, we built a PC with the 6950 XT that was budget friendly that you can check out right here. So check out our Robeytech Live YouTube channel down in the description below so you can like and subscribe to know when we go live and you don't miss another awesome build just like that one. If you have questions about this GPU or any other tech related questions, then check out our amazing Discord server over at discord.gg/Robeytech, filled with other tech and PC enthusiasts that would love to share their thoughts and ideas on these very subjects. Are you looking for cheap tech? I mean, you should always check out Newegg, but you can also check out at Robeytech.com or at Robeytech Deals on Twitter, where we have our guide Tom scouring the internet on all the best deals from things on tech, PC components, GPUs, you name it. And finally, you can follow me and my team on all the other socials at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. Anyway, guys, super appreciate AMD and Newegg for sponsoring this video. We hope you enjoyed this, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.